Florida Governor Ron DeSantis launched a blazing attack on Joe Biden's premiership yesterday, telling supporters in South Carolina that the president's fall on stage this week summed up America's decline.
Well, the Republican challenger told hundreds of Republicans that he wanted to send the president back to his basement in Delaware.
Yeah, fighting talk there. Let's speak now to our US and international politics professor, Scott Lucas. Good morning to you, Scott. So say what you like about American politics. It's never boring. And here we go again, all guns blazing. Ron DeSantis taking a huge swipe at Joe Biden. What do you make of it?
I mean, Joe Biden was back on his feet very quickly after a trip on a stage. He not only attended that ceremony, he then gave a nationally televised address from the Oval Office on Friday night. He then signed on Saturday the very important and essential bill to lift the U.S. debt ceiling to avoid an economic crisis. He's meeting Rishi Sunak, as you noted, this week to discuss important issues such as the Russian aggression in Ukraine. Which are the issues that we should be talking about? Ron DeSantis looked for a cheap headline. Fair enough, you know, he just got it. But it would probably be more important for Ron DeSantis, if he wants to be exciting, to actually address issues like economic issues, including the latest jobs report, the latest report on inflation, immigration, women's rights, LGBT rights, abortion, all of those issues like health care, which are going to concern Americans, rather than repeating the fairly tired old line that Donald Trump tried in 2020 about Sleepy Joe.
Yeah, but it's fair to say, though, he said in the speech, our country continues to stub its toe. Our country continues to trip and fall. Our country continues to go in the wrong direction. He's, of course, talking about soaring inflation, interest rates, particularly food inflation, the price of gas hitting a lot of Americans in the pocket. And also the open border with Mexico. There's been calamity over some laws that Biden has signed. So he was using the fall as a metaphor for the state of the nation. Are you saying that none of those points are valid?
But inflation's fallen 9 out of the past 10 months in a row. It's at its lowest point since the pandemic. U.S. unemployment is at its lowest rate since 1969. Including better than expected jobs increases yesterday. The infrastructure bill has led to an unprecedented amount of investment in bridges, roads, the internet, the bill for a green economy. And, you know, these investments as we move to try to protect both energy and the environment, a bill passed with Republican support is being implemented. So where is this country which is in terminal decline? Again, that's a cheap line to grab a headline, but it doesn't have substance. So Mr. DeSantis, as was said by Walter Mondale, Gary Hart in 1984, where's the beef? Mm. Where's the beef in your policies rather than simply taking lines that actually aren't connected with the facts to get a headline?
Well, DeSantis will also be alarmingly aware of his position in the polls. He is trailing behind Trump, that gap only widening since that chaotic campaign launch.
Yeah, and I think that's a fair point to talk, not just about the fact that Donald Trump is there, but there are a lot of other Republican candidates as well. For example, Mike Pence, who was once vice president, you might remember, will make his announcement on Wednesday. Nikki Haley, the former U.S. ambassador to the U.N., has declared. Tim Scott, the first major black candidate to run for the Republican nomination, has declared. Indeed, there were 8 candidates, including Mr. DeSantis, in Iowa yesterday at one of the barbecues that traditionally open up campaigning. The one person who wasn't there was Donald Trump.
Can we have a quick word? Sorry, Martin. Can we have a quick word on Mike Pence, just because you've mentioned that? Because that is an extraordinary situation, isn't it, Scott, that a former VP is running against a former president? Or could be on Wednesday.
It's not just the fact that a former VP is running against a former president. It's extraordinary that in the context that on January 6, 2021, when Mike Pence's life was being threatened by people who attacked the Capitol, Donald Trump, according to the documents that we have, didn't protect him. So there's a bit of a urgent context, which is there. I think you're going to see Pence try to make the argument that America needs to return to stability. It needs to return to a politics which is not based on division, which will position him, I think, not just against Donald Trump, but probably against Mr. DeSantis, who is going to try to out-Trump Trump with some of his lines.
Do you think maybe that's what this is about, attacking Joe Biden, going for the Sleepy Joe, the basement stuff, the falling over At the moment, Trump's on 43%, DeSantis only on 18%. The candidates you mentioned there are struggling to even break double digits. Is this just a kind of jousting contest in the red camp, if you like, to be the most outspoken, the most controversial, grab the headlines? It's all about winning the Republican vote, not actually swaying the nation.
Well, it's two things. First of all, you know, the polls, look, polls in 2015 at this point had Jeb Bush ahead. Where is he now? You know, we're still 9 months away from the first primary, so be careful with that. But the two things are, one is, yes, you nailed it. Ron DeSantis is trying to take Donald Trump's attack lines over Joe Biden and trying to turn it up to 11, so to speak. But secondly, Ron DeSantis has decided that rather run a campaign on issues, rather than run a campaign which talks about uniting Americans, he's going to try to run this red meat, fire-breathing attack with this idea of woke, whatever woke means. And of course, it really doesn't mean much the way that he phrases it. He's going to whip up the idea of culture wars. He's going to whip up the idea, in fact, of division rather than actually addressing the issues. The question is, how many Americans want to go for that type of divisive approach rather than actually trying to get to grips with the very real issues that are affecting them on a day-to-day basis?
Okay. Can we touch upon Joe Biden? Because age is a great concern, isn't it, for voters in the US? And people will be thinking, first of all, is this the very best that the Democrats can offer? And secondly, they'll be concerned about if he wins this second term, he'll be 86 years old.
Yeah, he'll be 82 when he takes office, and he'll be 86 when he finishes. You're absolutely right. But I'm going to put quote by a guy named Ronald Reagan. You remember him back in 1984 when he ran against Walter Mondale when he was in his late 70s, a bit younger than Joe Biden. But he said, I know age is going to be an issue in this campaign, but I'm not going to make a big deal about my opponent's inexperience. The fact of the point here is that you've got politicians here. You've got politicians. Well, the Queen was 96 and was still ruling this country. The question is not a number. The question is the person in charge still mentally and physically able to run the country, to exude that confidence that America needs, and to set a good tone in terms of character, decency, and tolerance? That will have to be a choice for voters. But the fact is that Joe Biden, who has been in his late 70s in his first term, has presided over an administration which has passed the most extensive domestic legislation, infrastructure, the economy, green energy, dealing with coronavirus, the most extensive legislation that the U.S. has had since the 1960s, and he has done it with some Republican support.
Okay, Professor Scott Lucas, thank you very much for your input this morning. Much appreciated.
Thank you.
So it's got to be said, he wasn't much of a fan of DeSantis. He very much liked Joe Biden. It's worth pointing out that the culture war stuff that DeSantis, as it's labelled there by Professor Lucas, has gone down very well in Florida, where DeSantis is the governor. He's got critical race theory out of schools, the Disney organization based in Florida, pushing the trans agenda on children. He kind of went to war with Disney. It actually played out very, very well with voters in Florida, which, of course, is the big red state. So I think to say it's a culture war that's non-existent is a bit harsh.
Yeah.
He's responding to stuff that's happening, and it's going down well.